So we are discussing basic operations. We have completed folding or time reversal operation. Shifting also we have seen. Total 4 cases will be there. Left shifting or right shifting. And scaling operations we need to discuss. Put the heading scaling. So first let us start with the time scaling operations. So this time scaling operation do not modify amplitude values of the signal. It is going to change. It is going to convert only time scale, only time axis is going to be modified using this operation. Okay, so to better understand this, let us take this example x of t. Let us take the limits from minus 4 to 4 and take amplitude as 2 rectangular pulse. Using rectangular gate pulse we can represent, or else from this I can write mathematically x of t. What is its amplitude value? 2 for the limits minus 4 to plus 4. Means over the range of minus infinite to infinite, signal is defined only from minus 4 to 4. What is its amplitude? It is constant. If it is varying, I have to divide the limits. Constant amplitude 2 is there, so I have written for remaining t values, its amplitude is 0. So mathematical representation I am having, graphical representation I am having. Time scaling means, let us divide it by 2. Means t is going to be multiplied or divided by some constant. So here t I have divided with 2. Now I have to sketch the signal for this. New signal x of t by 2 I have to plot. For this, same as shifting operation, 2 I cannot modify, isn't it? If any t variable is there, I will replace this with t by 2. T is not there. So as it is 2 I am writing minus 4. Limits also I have to write t by 2, 4. Okay? 0, else conditions for remaining all the values of t. So now limits always we have to write in terms of t variable. Minus 8 less than or equal to 8. So this is anyhow 0 elsewhere. Because 0 amplitude we don't bother. Amplitude is 0 means no need to represent it at all. Okay. Now if I plot this x of t by 2. Now what is the amplitude? Amplitude is 2 for t ranging from minus 8 to 8. Means minus 8 to 8. Constant amplitude 2 is there. So you can observe here. X of t limits are from minus 4 to 4. When t is divided by 2, its limits are being multiplied by 8. So signal is being stretched, expanded. Okay, simply without writing this limits also, instead of substituting t with t by 2 also, directly I can write t by 2 means there won't be any change in amplitudes, only limits I have to multiply with 2. 4 into 2, 8. 4 into 2, 8. So this is time scaling operation. So let us plot x of 2t now. This is x of t by 2 when t is divided by some constant 2. So now let us plot the signal 2t. X of 2t, take this definition, 2 as it is, minus 4, 2t, 4, elsewhere. Okay, now write the limits in terms of t variable. Minus 4 by 2 means minus 2. 4 by 2 means 2. 0 elsewhere. These are the limits for my new signal x of 2t. Now try to plot x of 2t. Okay. What is the amplitude? It is constant from the ranges. T ranging is from minus 2 to 2 only. You can observe here. X of t limits are from minus 4 to 4. X of 2t limits. Amplitude no change at all. But 4 as being divided by 2. Minus 2 to 2. In this case, signal is compressed. So So when t is multiplied with an integer, the signal is compressed. When t is divided with some constant, t signal is being expanded. These two we have observed just now. Expansion of a signal, compression of a signal during time scaling. So during time scaling operation, there won't be any change in the amplitude of the signal. Only time values are going to be modified. Time values are going to be either multiplied or divided based on the operations. Expansion or compressing operation. Okay, this is about time scaling. Let us go for the last one, amplitude scaling operation. Now amplitude scaling means there won't be any change in time axis. Only amplitude values are going to be modified. Means, now what is my signal here? This is x of t. Right? Limits I have taken from minus 4 to 4. So here, amplitude scaling means amplitude is going to be multiplied with some constant. 4 into x of t. Limits I should not change. But whatever amplitude is, 2 is there. 4 into 2. 8. Amplitude is constant amplitude. So this amplitude is going to be modified. Suppose if I want to plot x of t, amplitude is divided by 2. Previously it is like x of t by 2. Now it is x of t by 2. Means its amplitude is 2. X of t by 2 means 2 by 2 is 1. So amplitude is going to be 1. Time axis will be same. Like this. So these are the various operations on signals. Like folding, shifting, scaling, time scaling, amplitude scaling and all. So let us see with one example. Finish this. Plot the signal x of t equal to r of t minus signal x of t equal to r of t minus 1. See here, it can be a plus also, multiplication also, whatever. Okay, simply subtraction I have taken. For this, first what we have to do here is, simply first I have to draw the signal, first signal r of t. R of t means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 will be there. Here amplitude will be 1, here amplitude will be 2, at 3, linear, right? At 4, amplitude will be 4, okay? So now let us plot the signal x of t equal to r of t minus 1. Here subtraction is there, instead of minus plus may be there or multiplication may be there. For this what we have to do first, let us sketch the signal r of t. R of t is a linear ramp, right? At t equal to 0 amplitude will be 0, at t equal to 1 amplitude will be 1, at t equal to 2 amplitude will be 2, at t equal to 3 amplitude will be 3. Because r of t equal to t, linear ramp. Next, r of t minus 1 means r of t signal is going to be right shifted by 1 time. Right shifted by 1 time means at t equal to 0 whatever amplitude is there, that is going to be shifted to 1. At t equal to 1 what is the amplitude is there? 1. That is going to be shifted to 2. At t equal to 2 whatever amplitude is there, that is going to be shifted to 3. Right shifted. At t equal to 3, what is the amplitude? 3 is there. So at t equal to 4, amplitude is going to be 3, right shifted. So this is my r of t minus 1. Now we have to subtract r of t from r of t minus 1. Okay? This is my resultant signal I am going to plot. Okay? So, at t equal to 0, amplitude is 0. Here also 0 is there. Next at t equal to 1, 1 is there. At t equal to 1, 1 is there. So 1, amplitude is 1. Next at t equal to 2, 2 is there. At t equal to 2, 1 is there. 2 minus 1, please analyze yourself. 1. Next at t equal to 3, 3 is there. At t equal to 3, 2 is there. So 3 minus 2, again 1. So, this we are going to get completely it as t only. So, at t equal to 0, we are having 0 amplitude. Here also 0 amplitude. So, this is the graph. It is starting from 1 only. Exactly at t equal to 1, 0. Here 1 is there. 1 minus 0, 1 amplitude. Remaining all the samples here. Here 0 is there. But whereas here some linear curve is there, na? So 0 to 1. At t equal to 0.5, what is the amplitude I am having? 0.5. Here there is no amplitude. So we are going to get it as like this. Okay. Please understand. You have to understand this. At t equal to 0.5, what is the amplitude? 0.5. But at t equal to 0.5, there is no amplitude here. 0.5 minus 0, 0.5. Okay, this is 0.5. For remaining all the values, I am going to get constant amplitude. That is 1. So this is about sketching the signals, performing operations. Similarly, the relations. If you see the relation, easily you can understand. Signum of t, 2 into u of t minus 1. Please verify this relation. Means, sketch the signal 2 into u of t minus 1. You will get it as signum of t. Next, few more relations. Delta of t equal to d into u of t by dt. Means, if we differentiate unit step signal, we are going to get unit impulse. Similarly, u of t is d into ramp signal. Okay. Next, r of t is d into p of t by dt. So, these are some relations. Similarly, if I write in terms of integration, like integration means if I apply integration both the sides, differentiation will get cancelled, right? So, integration of u of t dt equal to r of t. Next, integration of r of t into dt equal to p of t. Like this. These are the relations we are having. In quiz questions, we may expect this. Delta of t equal to d into u of t by dt. Integration of delta of t is u of t. Both the sides you apply integration. Easily we can write this. Integration of u of t is r of t. Integration of r of t is differentiation will get cancelled, p of t. Integration of delta of t is u of t. So these are the relations and operations on signals. Okay?